Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to record and edit audio in Tracktion 7. We'll cover the audio track setup, recording from our audio interface, and how to make some basic edits like moving around and trimming the tracks. Before starting this tutorial, just make sure you've checked out the previous videos in this series. The first thing we need to cover is how to add and remove tracks and Tracktion so that we can have enough for all the inputs we need without extras cluttering up the project. To add a track, right-click on the track area below our tracks and select Create a New Track. We can also add a new track from the bottom menus by selecting Create a New Track under Tracks. If we need to get rid of an extra track, right-click on it and select Delete the selected track. By right-clicking, we can also expand the tracks to make them bigger for easier editing, or shrink them down so we can fit more on our screen. We can also double-click a track to expand it. With our track selected after clicking on it, we get a few more options on the bottom panel. If we double-click on the track name, we can rename it so we know exactly what's on the individual tracks. The next thing we need to do is set up an input for our track. To do that, click the rectangle underneath the track name in the track section. When you click this, it gives us a dropdown with the input listing. Then we can select our input. In this case, it gives us a mono input. Once the input is selected, we get the input controls in the bottom section of the window. We can enable stereo recording here, live input monitoring, and make adjustments to the input gain and audio recording quality. When we enable tree to stereo channel pair, we'll lose the input and have to reselect it, but all the inputs are now available in stereo pairs. To go back to mono, just undo this. If you plan on recording multiple instruments or using MIDI, I recommend recording all your instruments with a click track. To do this, select the click track menu in the bottom left corner. Select the turn on click track button. I also recommend selecting a count in time of 1 or 2 bars so you can start right on time. Here we can also adjust the volume. The click track will play during both playback and recording, but we can select the button to play it only during recording, and this can make it easier to hear if our instruments are in time with each other. I also usually set my click track to emphasize the first beat of every bar. Once all that's set up, press the red circle on each track to arm it for recording. Only armed tracks will record, and all the others will play back normally. Then press the red record button on the transport to start recording. To make things easier, you can also start and stop recording by pressing the R key on the keyboard. After we're done recording, we can make some edits to the clip. Dragging the top part of the clip around will move it on the timeline. We can also do this with or without snapping by enabling and disabling it in the bottom right corner. The empty square will allow us to drag the clip boundaries around on the timeline, but the audio track in relation to the timeline remains the same. With the track in the right place, we can trim the ends and remove extra noise. The empty triangle keeps the audio in the same place and trims the end of the clip. This is what we used when we started recording a clip early and stopped late and want to get rid of the excess. If we use the filled-in triangle, it moves the edge of the clip but pushes all the audio with it. The last thing we'll cover in this video is how to apply a fade to a clip. To apply a fade, click and drag the square with the diagonal line towards the center of the clip. Then in the bottom section with the clip settings, we can choose the fade shape or fine-tune the timing by manually entering it. Thanks for checking out this video on audio recording and editing in Tracktion 7. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for social media links to stay up to date on all our new content.